I'm not going to lie to you. Billy Boy would not do that. There's a lot in this one, so let's get going. Remember, there are three global systems and two local systems that we're going through. We already had the global pressure belts. Now we're going to tackle the global surface winds. In a little while, we'll be going through the global upper air currents, the jet stream. Then we're going to go through the local pressure systems and the local winds. Let's do a quick recap here. Let's take a look at the pressure belts. Remember, there are seven global pressure belts. We've got the equatorial low that centers on the equator, the subtropical highs that center on 30 degrees north and south. I love this diagram. It just doesn't show much of the southern hemisphere. I'm going to focus on the northern hemisphere, but know that this replicates in the southern hemisphere. There's the subpolar lows that are at 60 degrees north and south, and then the polar highs that are at 90 degrees north and south. And remember, the equatorial low and the polar highs are thermally induced pressure belts. The subtropical highs and the subpolar lows are dynamically induced pressure belts. Remember, we name winds by the direction they come from, not the direction they're going to. So look here, between 5 and 25 degrees in both hemispheres, that means 5 degrees north to 25 degrees north and 5 degrees south to 25 degrees south, there is a consistent and general easterly flow of wind. In other words, the air is blowing out of the east. We call these winds the tropical easterlies or the trade winds. And they are found, again, in both hemispheres, the northern and southern hemispheres, between 5 and 25 degrees. If you've ever been to Hawaii, you know that the breeze is kind of always blowing there. It's like 18 of 24 hours a day, you got a little bit of a wind going. Or if you've ever seen pictures of Hawaii, the palm trees always seem to be bent a little bit. Then, between 35 and 55 degrees in both hemispheres, so that means 35 degrees north to 55 degrees north and 35 degrees south to 55 degrees south, there is a general and consistent westerly flow of air. We call these winds the westerly winds or the westerlies. Both of those terms are perfectly fine. Now notice this, that in California, especially Southern California, Los Angeles is at 34 degrees north. And the southern part of Orange County is at 33 degrees north, which means we're kind of right on the cusp of this. And that has a direct impact on what happens with our weather and our climate. Because sometimes we're in the westerly winds, which allows for storms that are out in the Pacific to come to us. And sometimes we're not in the westerly winds. But if you're up in Oregon, Washington, British Columbia, they are always sitting in the westerly winds. And as a result of that, those areas tend to be significantly wetter than Southern California. Now notice that between 65 and 85 degrees in both hemispheres, that means 65 degrees north to 85 degrees north and 65 degrees south to 85 degrees south, there is a consistent easterly flow of air. We call these the polar easterlies. I just put on the circulation around the major high pressure systems. Let's take a look especially at the subtropical highs in the northern hemisphere and notice the clockwise circulation. So first, take a look at where the trade winds, the tropical easterlies, are at between 5 and 25 degrees in the northern hemisphere. And notice that as the air circulates around the high pressure systems that center on 30 degrees north, it's a little bit like pitching the softball underhand or bowling. Out of the southern end, the air rolls out like you're pitching the softball underhanded. And then as it rolls out of that southern end of the high pressure system, it creates those easterly winds. And then on the northern end of the subtropical highs, notice it's like throwing a baseball overhand, where the air comes out of the top end, the northern end, and that creates the westerly winds. Then you can see in the southern hemisphere, I put part of the circulation around, and that circulation is pointing out this same thing, where in the southern hemisphere, of course, the air is going to circulate counterclockwise around a high pressure system. So at 30 degrees south, the air circulates counterclockwise, and you can see that that air comes out of the northern end of it, and when it does, out of that subtropical high, it creates that easterly wind flow. You can hear the dog next door barking. The dog never stops barking. Then notice up the very far northern part of this diagram, you can see that as the air circulates around the polar high, that circulation creates the polar easterlies. What happens between the belts? So for example, along the equator? Well, along the equator, we have multiple things happening. First of all, you know the equatorial low is there, so it's converging rising air. But in addition to that, that area is also referred to as the ITCZ. ITCZ stands for Intertropical Convergence Zone. Intertropical, because you remember, the tropical zone goes from 23.5 degrees north to 23.5 degrees south. So the tropical zone is in both the northern and southern hemispheres. Therefore, there's a northern part of the tropical zone and a southern part of the tropical zone. The equator sits right between them, therefore, intertropical. And then convergence zone, because what happens with low pressure? The air converges and rises. ITCZ is common within the parlance of meteorology when you're talking about that part of the planet. So the ITCZ is the intertropical convergence zone. It centers on the equator. This area is also sometimes referred to as the doldrums. Now, this is an antiquated term. It comes from the time when Europeans were sailing around conquering the world hundreds of years ago. Their primary energy source, of course, was the wind. And when they would cross the equator, their ships would become becalmed. It's called BECALMED, which means they would stop moving. And they started referring to that area as the doldrums. Doldrums is an old word that means dull because the ship wouldn't be moving. Then again, at 30 degrees north and 30 degrees south, we have an area where there is no consistent wind flow. Just like at the equator, there's no consistent wind flow. There's no consistent wind flow here either. This area, by those ancient mariners from hundreds of years ago, began to be referred to as the horse latitudes. So, as a quick recap, along the equator, there is no consistent wind flow. And at 30 degrees north and south, there's no consistent wind flow. The winds are found from 5 to 25, then 35 to 55, and then 65 to 85. But on those strips where you have 0 degrees and 30 degrees, there tends to be no consistent wind flow, and these ancient mariners gave those areas names, the doldrums and the horse latitudes.